Woodley High was my kingdom. I ruled and conquered everything and everyone in my way. It was expected of me. It was my duty. Modesty was never an option for me. I was good at everything and I knew it. They all knew it and loved me for it. Even those who hated me still respected me. I was the basketball captain and everyone's choice for homecoming king. College scouts were begging to have a minute of my time. I was every girl's high school dream. I was the envy of all my peers. Those who were not my friends wished they were. I was on top of Woodley High's food chain. I was unstoppable. This is the story of how I lost my kingdom and how a simple promise of fame and prestige made the three hottest girls at Woodley High fight over me. Wanna know who won? Stick around and find out. Hi, Han, what's up?
Hey, are you free tonight? Dad's in town and we're having a good luck dinner for him before Saturday's game. I'm calling to invite you.
I'm free, but are you sure he wants me there? I mean, he's the basketball coach at Greenfield High. They're our biggest rival team in the state, and we're playing them in the championship final on Saturday.
Of course he wants you there. You're my childhood friend, and that's more important than a game. Come on, it'll be fun. Plus, you might learn a thing or two about his tactics.
Well, if you put it like that. Okay, I'll be there. See you in an hour. 2 hours later, dinner was served. At the table was Hannah, her parents, and me.
So, Asher, you guys ready to lose on Saturday?
Haha, nice try, Mr. Davis. We're ready to win. Your team doesn't stand a chance.
Confident, I like it. May the best team win. See you out on the court, son.
I can't wait for this game to be over already. I hate having to choose between you and Dad.
After dinner, we were in the den watching TV. Hannah's mom looked like she'd burst into tears any minute.
Mom, what's wrong?
It's nothing for you to worry about, dear. It's just that the school is looking to replace me as coach for next season. The only way I keep my job is if I win Saturday's game.
What? But you've been their coach for years. They can't just fire you, can they?
I'm afraid they can, dear. I have to win the championship or I'm out.
Hannah's mom was full on sobbing now, her dad rubbing her shoulders lovingly. I felt like I was intruding a private family moment, so I said my goodbyes and left. Later that night, my phone rang and I checked to see it was a video chat request from Hannah. Hi, Han. How's your mom? I'm sorry I had to leave. I thought I should give you guys some space. How are you?
It's okay, Ash. I'd have left with you, but my parents needed me. Mom's sleeping now, but I can hear Dad pacing upstairs in their bedroom. I don't know what to do. I'm worried about him. I overheard him say that we might lose our house and I may not go to college.
Are you sure? I didn't know things were that bad. I wish there was something I could do to help. I'm so sorry.
He may not lose the game anyway. I know that would mean you losing. This sucks.
If losing the championship means your dad gets to keep his job in the house and you get to go to college, then it's not such a bad outcome. I can live with it. A day later, as I stood with my team waiting to play the biggest game of the year, maybe even our lives, I made a decision. I decided to help Mr. Davis win the game by throwing the game. I missed free throws, I missed passes, I committed deliberate fouls and lost the championship to Greenfield High. After the game, I ran to the locker room and called my mom and confessed.
You what?
Except it was not my mom behind me. It was my teammate, Carl.
Please tell me you didn't actually lose us the biggest game of our high school careers?
Carl, He didn't wait for me to finish. He punched me right in the face and walked off. That day, I had walked onto the court a hero, a leader, and a warrior. I left a villain, a pariah, and the most hated person in all of Woodley High. I was no longer king. People crossed to the other side when they saw me walking their way. My girlfriend Erica broke up with me in front of the entire class. I was stripped of the captaincy, and college scouts withdrew the scholarship offers they had offered me, and some of my teammates. My grades took a dive. My life became a nightmare.
Months later.
Asher, hey! Mind if I join you? You can even have some of my food.
Erica had not spoken to me since the breakup. Erica, what are you doing? Are you sure you should be talking to me in front of your friends?
I'm sorry. Senior year has been so busy, and I've barely had time to socialize. But I'm here now. We're still cool, right?
Cool? You basically ghosted me after humiliating me. You blocked me on all your social media accounts and your phone. You moved your desk away from mine, and you walked the other way when you see me at school.
What was I supposed to do after what you did? It was either that or go down with you. Please tell me you understand and you forgive me. Please, Ash, I miss you.
All right, sit. What do you want?
I want to be friends again. I know we might never get back together, but we can still be friends. We can hang out at school and do whatever you feel like.
This was too good to be true. Okay, I'll think about it. You better not be up to something.
Great. I've sent you friend requests on all my socials. This is fun. Yay!
What just happened? The afternoon classes were uneventful, except for a few winks and smiles from Erica. When the last bell rang, I hurried out of class before she could catch up with me. Something about the whole thing did not feel right. I was running through the school parking lot when I bumped into someone, literally. My books and papers went flying right out of my arms.
Asher, are you all right? I'm so sorry. Let me help.
I was in a squatting position trying to retrieve my books before the wind got them. I looked up at the sound of the familiar voice. Ashley? What? Ashley was the head cheerleader and one of the hottest girls at school. She and I used to run in the same social circles, although Erica never liked her. Like Erica, she barely looked my way this year.
Actually, I'm glad I bumped into you. There's a party this weekend at my dad's beach house. We're even planning to light a bonfire. Will you come? I'd love to have you there. It's on Saturday. I hope you remember how to get there. If not, give me a call. See you.
I was now sure I'd somehow hit my head and woken up in an alternate universe. It was almost dark when I arrived at the beach house.
Ash! Oh my god, you came! I'm so happy to see you!
Ashley threw herself into my arms and almost tackled me to the ground.
What on earth is going on here? Ash, what are you doing here?
Erica stood watching us, hands on her hips.
Back off, Jerrican. Asher is my guest. You had a chance to ask him to attend with you, but you didn't. You snooze, you lose. He's with me tonight.
We will see about that. And my name is Erica.
Erica grabbed my hand and yanked me away from Ashley's arms. Girls, I'm not looking for trouble, so I think I'll leave.
I'll leave with you.
No, he won't. You leave. You're no longer welcome here. Come on, Ash.
I had seen enough. I turned and walked back to my car, then drove home. So much for having friends again. On Monday morning, Lisa, the student body president, summoned me to her office. It was more of a closet than an office. Hi, I'm Asher. You asked to see me?
Have a seat. So, how has senior year been treating you? I know you've been having some challenges. Have you decided where you want to go to college?
It has been quite an adjustment, but I'm surviving. To be honest, I might not go to college. My grades are not so good lately, plus I doubt there's anyone willing to write a recommendation letter for me.
That's sort of why I called you here. I may have a way to help you get accepted to a few colleges. As the student body president, I'll personally write you a recommendation letter. I could also get the principal and the basketball coach to write you letters too.
Slow clapping sounds came from behind me.
Well, well, well. Abusing your office, Liza? That's if you could even call it that. If Ash needs a good word put in with the coach, I'm happy to do it. I can even get him back on the team. Or did you forget that I'm head cheerleader?
Get him back on the team, please. Your job is to look pretty, cheer, and clap for others, Ashley. Leave the actual work to me.
Whatever, livid Liza. I'll be in the gymnasium waiting to actually introduce Ash to the new coach, not sitting in my closet of an office making empty promises.
How dare you?
I was on my feet and out the door before this turned into another screaming match.
Asher, wait! We're not done talking. I need to help you.
She needed to help me? Throughout the week, Ashley and Erica sat next to me in class. During lunch, they fought over who'd carry my tray. Erica even offered to carry my books to and from class. I have to admit, it was a little flattering. Okay, a lot flattering. I was feeling like my old self. I even started to look forward to going to school again. But as with every fairy tale, my newfound happiness didn't last. I was naive to think it would. I got home from school one evening and found my brother Nate preparing dinner with Mom. Nate, what? When did you get here?
Baby brother, it's so good to see you. Come here.
Nate scooped me into his arms and spun me around. He always did this whenever he came home after being away for months at some fancy location shooting a blockbuster movie. My big brother was a famous movie star. Geez, put me down. I'm not your baby brother anymore.
You'll always be my baby brother, and I'll always look out for you.
After dinner, Nate and I were watching television when his phone rang. He declined the call, but not before I saw the caller ID. It said Erica Woodley High. Nate, why is my former girlfriend calling you? Are you two involved?
No, what do you take me for? It's nothing, Ash. Forget you saw anything.
Fine, if you won't tell me, then she will. I'm calling her now.
Don't. I'll tell you everything you want to know. I bet you've had quite an interesting week at school, right?
How do you even know about her? Nate, what did you do?
2 weeks ago.
OMG! You're Nathaniel Jeffries. You're, like, so famous.
Well, I rolled my eyes. Why did I think it was a good idea to attend a high school party?
Hey, gorgeous. I prefer Nate. Nathaniel is for my parents when they're really angry with me. You must be Ashley.
Ashley was practically bouncing on her feet.
I can't believe you're at my party. Guys, everyone, look who...
Shh, I'd rather people don't know who I am. Can you keep a secret, Ashley?
Of course. My lips are zips.
Zipped.
Huh? Whatever, Jerrican.
Erica turned to me, effectively dismissing Ashley.
What are you doing here, Nate?
It's my party, duh. I get to ask him that question.
I'm here on assignment. I'm here because of Asher.
Ugh, loser Asher? He's like a loser.
Erica shifted uncomfortably.
Well, after what happened last semester, someone decided to make a movie based on Asher's story. And they've asked me to play Asher's role.
Well then, you came to the wrong place. He's not here. Maybe try the dustiest corner in the school library.
Shouldn't you just call him? I mean, he's your bro-
I will. I wanted to talk to you girls first. The show producers want to start filming after graduation. They've asked me to pick one of Asher's friends to be in the movie with me.
Good luck with that. He no longer has friends. Even Little Miss Perfect here broke up with him.
I know that. That's why I have an exciting opportunity for one of you girls.
Yes.
Erica rolled her eyes.
Yeah. I love your enthusiasm. How would you girls feel about starring in the movie?
O-M-G.
Erica feigned disinterest, but I knew she was definitely interested. So this whole week, they thought they were auditioning for a movie?
Yes, I told them that to audition, they needed to befriend you and spend time with you in and out of school. Someone from the show would be observing their interactions with you until the end of the semester, then pick one of them to be my co-star.
Nate, please tell me there's no such movie being made.
Of course there isn't. I'm just in town to research a role I got in an upcoming movie. I'm playing a high school football captain. It's the reason I was at Ashley's party.
What about Liza? Was she also auditioning when she offered to get me into college?
Yes and no. She overheard me at Ashley's party and approached me at the party later. She wasn't interested in befriending you, but she offered to get you the recommendation letters in exchange for a job on set during filming.
Why did you do all this?
To help you, of course. I thought you could use a few friends, and who better than the two most popular girls at school? Liza was just an added bonus. Is it working?
If by working you mean I no longer have a single moment to myself, then yeah, it's working.
Isn't that a good thing? You don't look happy. I expected a little more gratitude.
I'm grateful, Nate, really. I know you were just looking out for me. And in a way, you did help. I finally realized that I don't need to be popular anymore. I like my life just the way it is now. If it's all right, I'd like you to call off the girls, please. As for Liza, I sure could use those letters, but not under false pretense.
I'll call them off right now if that's what you want, Ash. As for Liza, I'll get her a temp job on the actual movie I'm researching for. I'm sure that'll be enough, and she'll still get you those letters.
Nate dialed Erica's number. Monday is going to be a very interesting day. Hi, I'm Brick. I consider myself to be a pretty attractive guy, but for some reason, the girls in my school didn't feel the same way. I was a few months away from graduating high school, and I had never dated anyone. I didn't know what it felt like to be kissed because I had never been kissed before. You think that's crazy? Wait till you see what happens at the end of this video. I never thought of this as a bad thing until I got in an argument with Sandra, the most beautiful girl in my class. She had torn my class notebook, and when I told her to go get it fixed, she told me that it was simply a mistake and I should go get it fixed myself. This really annoyed me. Why should I fix a notebook you spoiled? I insisted that she must fix it, and as she picked the book from my desk, she murmured something. I didn't hear her clearly, so I asked her to repeat it.
This is why no girl likes you!
She screamed.
You're so mean and uncool, and I'm sure that nobody would ever want to press their lips on such mean lips.
She put the book in her school bag and angrily walked away, slamming the door behind her. Wow, I thought, no girls like me? For the first time in my life, I felt like a total loser. I could feel tears well up in my eyes. I didn't want anyone to see me crying because it would ruin my reputation, so I had to hide somewhere. I dashed straight into the first open door I could see, and it turned out to be the janitor's supply closet. I had slightly brushed someone's shoulder with mine during my short sprint from the janitor's closet, but I didn't even care. I backed into a corner and wailed. It was so loud that I hoped and prayed that students walking on the other side of the door wouldn't hear my pathetic voice. After a few minutes, I looked up. I could feel a presence. It seemed like someone was in the room with me. I quickly put on the light and looked around, but no one was there. It was only a pile of supplies that took the shape of a human. Phew, I thought, I'm alone here. But then I noticed the shadow of 2 feet right in front of my door. Someone was standing on the other side. "Who is that?" I screamed. "Leave immediately or I'll have you beaten up." For the first time, I really heard myself talk, and what Sandra said was true. I was a mean person. I started crying again. The person on the other side of the door had turned to leave after my threat, but immediately came back when I resumed my wailing. This time, the person opened the door and came in. It was Sandra.
"I'm sorry about what I said. It was inconsiderate and really harsh,"
she said, sitting down right beside me. "You weren't wrong, you know. No one likes me. I haven't even been kissed before." I wanted to start crying again, but Sandra leaned in and gave me a long, soft kiss. This was the best thing I had ever experienced in my life, but it was quickly ruined when my biology teacher opened the door. She screamed and told me that she was going to report me to my parents for my bad behavior. You may think that it's not wrong for someone who's almost a high school graduate to kiss a girl, but my parents are very religious people. They would withdraw me from my school immediately if they found out. I guess that's one of the reasons I had never dated, apart from my meanness. I raced after my teacher and begged her not to tell my parents. I told her that I was ready to do anything, but she just wouldn't listen. She simply said that there was nothing I could do to change her mind, and that first thing on Monday morning, she was going to call my parents to come to the school, and she would break the news to them. I was so confused and distraught. I didn't know what to do, so I stood there looking like a lost puppy. Sandra caught up to me, and I told her what the teacher had said.
"That's good news, then,"
she smiled like a crazy person.
"If she is going to call your parents first thing on Monday, then we have 2 whole days to change her mind."
She said that there was absolutely nothing I could do to convince her not to break the news to my parents. I had to repeat this to Sandra because she wasn't really making any sense. How do you convince someone who's out to get you? Sandra kept smiling without replying.